galaxy that we live in is the Milky Way. And our Milky Way galaxy has about 200 billion stars and our solar system. And the astronomical science also tells us that there are about 100 billion galaxies which are greater than our Milky Way in size, and all of them are in space receding from each other. Meaning, this is a beautiful information, an amazing information that all of us have. But most of us do not have the knowledge of who created this beautiful universe. Today, the mankind has discovered millions of species which were absolutely unknown before. But the mankind does not have the knowledge as to who created those species and who feeds them. Today, the medical science has discovered several functions of our body parts which are so highly organized that even the medical science is amazed with it. But the medical science, with all this information yet, has a shortcoming in acknowledging the only true God who created this beautiful body of the human beings. Information in the form of theories propounded by laureates of social, economy, political, and judiciary sciences are being experimented in the world in order to establish global peace. But these very biased laureates are resting on laurels, do not seem to make an effort to verify the divine message by which global peace can be established. The United States of America is supposed to be the superpower of our time. And this superpower is a unipolar superpower, is a superpower of a unipolar world. And the United States, along with its allies of the European Union, at least since 1970, has strived very hard to primarily produce and distribute selective information. And for the same, these countries have appointed a heavy bulk of their labor force to work for information-oriented occupations that have been made lucrative globally. But all these information-oriented occupations are heavily controlled by a particular group of people whom we may technically refer as the capitalists, the corporate state, and the bureaucrats. These corporate states, the bureaucrats, and the capitalists have worked hand in hand with the government organizational experts and have orchestrated a global system today that is totally dependent upon communication technologies and bureaucratic techniques. And the reason to do so was to ensure a free flow of regular, selective information to all the government departments in the world, to all the public and private departments in the world, and to all those who are the decision makers sponsored by the government and who play a catalyst role in swaying the public mood for or against an issue. These capitalists have become so successful in their evil approach that they have enforced international governments to allow them an unplanned and unchecked flow of commercial communication channels that include internationally renowned entertainment channels and internationally renowned news channels. And then these capitalists have used these internationally renowned entertainment channels to portray to the mankind the Don Juans and the social butterflies in the society as most successful men and women of our time and ambassadors of global peace. These entertainment channels have projected the seducers and the libertines of the time as the public heroes and icons of a money laundering society. And added to this situation is that these capitalists have viciously used the news channels in order to malign the religions, especially Islam, so that people are made to believe throughout the world that Islam does not befit the modern day criteria of establishing a global peace. But alhamdulillah, the positive side, the optimistic side of this whole issue is that Islam still remains an undefeated challenge to all the evils that have been perpetrated against it. And inshallah, Islam will remain an undefeated challenge for them. But not because you and me as Muslims have done too good to Islam, it is because Allah promised in the glorious Quran. In Surah Fatah, Surah number 48, Ayat number 28, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله وكيلا. It is He who sent His messenger with guidance and with a religion of truth to establish it, to make it prevail over all other systems of the world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is enough as a witness over this claim. It is very important that in times like this, all of us Muslims from different backgrounds unite together and strongly work hard to promote Islam in the right perspective of the teachings of the glorious Quran as were taught and practiced by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his Sahaba Akram radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, so that the world understands how can Islam establish global peace. As a step towards the same mission, I would like to first introduce historically Islam on a comparative religion basis. Many people have a misconception that Islam is a new religion that was founded by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam about 1430 years back. And they think that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam founded this religion for the welfare of the Arabs alone, and later, because of his teachings, his followers, the Sahaba Akram radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, on the point of the sword, they spread Islam upon the conquered races. Let me quote a prominent non-Muslim historian by the name D. Lacy O'Leary from his famous book, Islam at the Crossroads, published in the year 1923 from London, on page number 8, in this context, that Islam was spread by sword, he answers to this allegation and he says, history makes it clear, however, that the legend of the fanatical Muslims sweeping the world and forcing Islam at the point of the sword upon the conquered races is a fantastically absurd myth that the historians have again and again repeated. Let me also quote another non-Muslim historian, a popular historian by the name Thomas Carlyle, from his second lecture on the subject, Heroes, Hero Worship and the Heroic Deeds, that he delivered on 8 May 1940, in which he says about the sword that is generally alleged of Prophet Muhammad and the Sahaba. Thomas Carlyle says, the sword indeed, but where will you get that sword? Every new opinion at its starting is precisely a minority of one. One man believes in the whole world. One man against the whole world. That he picks up a sword to propagate his idea will do little for him. I would first ask you to get your sword. Meaning, even Thomas Carlyle says that it is not possible for such a great religion to be established only on the basis of a sword. And finally, I would like to quote in this context one of the great historians, Sir Bernard Shaw, from the book The Genuine Islam.